lot of you wonder, what should we do about our ceremony? What should we do about music? Some people even sometimes think about, say, well, maybe my DJ can take a speaker and just aim it out. What I want to show you firsthand is why that's not a good idea. I want to show you what we're going to do today and what is the right way. So follow me and I'll show you. If you look out that window, you'll see the altar and you'll see where the ceremony is going to take place. And on paper, it doesn't look like a really long distance. You can pan over and look over the DJ stand. Now, some people suggest that we run a speaker out the door and aim it towards the altar. Let me show you why you don't want to do that. So, I guess what people are thinking we might do is set up a speaker like here. Well, there's a couple of things wrong with that. One, it's going to sound really bad because that is 200 feet away. And a speaker blasting from here to here is just not going to sound good. Plus, it's going to have to be controlled from inside that room. So it's too far. Now, this is just one particular venue and one particular instance where you have a wedding reception and a wedding ceremony. But we do lots of ceremony reception combinations, and sometimes they're a little bit closer to one another. But this is a perfect example of why we want to show you the right way to do it. So what we're doing over here right now is actually a sound test, a sound check for the singer that's going to be doing a song, going to be singing a song during the ceremony. So what you'll see as we get a little closer is two really small speakers to the left and to the right. And you wouldn't even notice them if you weren't really looking for them. But it sounds really, really good. So come on up. We're still talking about the advantages of a separate wedding ceremony sound system and why you don't want to use the DJ sound system, where in this case is several hundred feet away. Why should we take the extra time and a little bit extra expense and do this? Well, check this out. Here's a separate sound system, a separate wireless microphone that's going to go on the officiant who will be standing at the altar. And then, of course, we just did our sound check, which for a little bit more money, if you have a singer, some people do, we have a wireless microphone located right over here. But ultimately, here we are at the altar. And if you come over here and look back, you'll see that it's clean. All we're going to be looking at is family, friends, and guests. Sound is stealth. It's clean. It's going to sound great. Your wedding ceremony technician, not DJ, wedding ceremony technician will be off to the side and will help ensure smooth sailing for all the music during the wedding ceremony. And that's all we want, of course, for sound for all of our wedding ceremonies. And we just wanted to give you a first-hand point of view of how a wedding ceremony sound system works, and we hope this helps you in your decision on whether or not to choose a wedding ceremony sound system. Thanks for watching.